All right, today I'm going to show you how to balance the lead, chords, slash harmonies, and bass within a mix. So at the moment we have this. All the volumes are set at zero, we're redlining, it is not off to the best start. First things first, even before we get into volume, we're gonna make sure the octaves are set correctly. So, chords. Sound good, chords with lead. Kind of around the same octave, so if we can go into lead, we can hit Command or Control A, and then Shift up. It will bump it up an octave, aka 12 semitones. Let's see if this fits a bit better. The lead definitely stands out a bit more as opposed to... They were kind of clashing the same areas. We could have kept this at a lower octave, would have required some like EQ cutting, but... Stands out way more on top of the mix if you want a bright lead. Also, bass, we'll test that with the chords. Notice how I'm referencing everything to the chords. The chords are going to be the fundamental bit and we'll pair the leads and the bass alongside that. Can't really hear the bass too much. Wonder if it's up too high of an octave. Select all, shift down. Way better, just gotta make sure our lowest notes are still audible, which looks like it's D sharp, which is great if it was too low. That ain't it. So we've got the bass and the lead octave set right against our chords. That sounds way better. The bass is pumping, the lead stands out on top, the chords are providing the harmonies and the backing goodness. It's time to select all these and drag them down in volume. Now we get into the volume actually. We can completely get rid of the lead and completely get rid of the bass. I like to go by ear, just drag it in and then see what sounds good and then reference it later when you're comparing it to other tracks. We'll gradually bring in the bass until it sounds decent. This is not going to be the end result for the volume. This is just a kind of placekeeper in a way. We've still got more work to do. Anyway, lead time. And now we begin the processing with audio effects. First things first, chords. We're going to chuck an EQ on that and do a low cut. Or a high pass, actually. All this area we want saved for the bass, so... See how it sounds now. Bass is getting through a bit better. A little bit clashy. Bass has got heaps of room now, it's a bit more clearer. And we'll do the same for the leads as well. We don't want any bass on these leads, so we'll EQ them out. And if you notice around here is where our chords are sitting, so we typically don't want them clashing too much, but we also don't want to strip the character from the lead, so. We'll see how the lead and chord interact now. Both are kind of like saw waves, so it's going to be typically harder to kind of set and balance these in the mix, hence I set myself this challenge. We could give the lead a bit more space with this EQ on the chords. Depends how much cut we want from the high end. That's sitting a bit better. Or we could even go into multiband dynamics. This is still on the chords. Set this audio input from our lead. And then above, set the ratio and the threshold. So you can hear the top end of the chords and the leads. So we'll do it before and after. We are definitely stripping the character from the chords, but we also want the lead to shine, so it's kind of like, where do we draw the line? Notice we're just compressing the high frequencies with the sidechain, we're leaving the mids and the low end. Bringing the bass, let's see how it's all sounding together again. Bass is a little bit too much. It's on its way. Stereo width, the chords are wide. Due to the unison on this. typically make the chords wide, lead mono-ish and bass mono-ish, so they all had their own spaces. For this example, lead typically mono, little bit stereo width, chords are wide, bass is mono. And if we want to get super technical, we could just chuck this multiband only on the mono part of the chord. Stay with me here. I'm going to group that multiband compressor. Also going to drag an EQ right before that. Change the mode from stereo to mid-side. This is just going to be mids. I'm going to get rid of the side frequencies completely. And we're going to also create new chain. Alt or option, drag this onto the new chain. This would be side and this would be mid. So for the side channel, we're going to bring that out again, change it to mid, and cut away those frequencies. So we should have a separate mid and side channel. So our sidechain multiband compression, the one that's doing the squishing when it's triggered by the lead, is only compressing our mids channel. The side is being left untouched because the lead's not occupying the sides, it's occupying the middle. So we don't need it to compress the sides, we need it to compress the middle. Now we can really compress this. And we can also exaggerate the sides now. Even fuller sound. And lastly, recheck the levels. We've been applying a lot of audio effects like EQ. So if you're taking away frequencies with the EQ, it's going to make your sound quieter because there's not as much going on anymore. Great, and then lastly, to squish them all together, chuck them in a group. That shortcut was Command G, and smash them with some saturation. Just a bit more glued together. See, one more thing, I want more frequencies with that bass. Way better.